All right, welcome Algebra 2. This is Mr. Adiano once again to provide you another tutorial. Today, we are just gonna focus on translations, all right? So today is just strictly on translations. Now, as you can see from this little chart that I made over here into the right-hand corner, you'll notice that I have what happens when we go up, what happens when we go down, what happens when we go left, and when we go right. So if you see here, when we go up, we have f of x right over here. We have f of x plus h. The h is just a number. It's on the outside. Here we have f of x minus h. The minus h is just a number. When we go to the left, inside our parentheses, because we're affecting our input and we're going on the x-axis, we're going to the left or to the right. In this case, if we're going left, it's going to be x plus a. And if we go to the right, it's going to be x minus a. So let's go ahead and get started. If you notice here, this dark line right here is our parent function. It should be kind of automatic for us to kind of notice that this is just f of x equals x squared. This is our parent function. This is the parent function for this solid line. What we want to find is this translated equation. So we know that it's quadratic, but we want it to get to this right here. So what do you notice happen from our vertex to go from here to this up here? Well, if you notice, we're gonna go to the right by 3, and then we're gonna go up by 1. We go to the right by 3 and then up 1 to get right there. All right, so I'm gonna write that down over in this corner. I'll write down, we went to the right by 3, and we went up by 1, okay? So now when I write my new equation, we're gonna do everything to our function in here. So if we go to the right, okay, what are we going to do inside our parentheses? Well, if you look here at this chart, if we go to the right, it's x minus a. The a is just the number that we go to the right by. So we went right by 3. We went to the right by 3. Therefore, we're going to have a minus sign inside. So we're going to get minus 3 squared. Okay. And then what's the last thing? So we took care of this. Now we need to take care of this last portion, is that we went up by 1. So let's look at our chart. When we go up, we're gonna have a plus whatever that number was, plus h, whatever that number is that we went up by. In this case, we went up by 1, so we're just gonna do plus 1. And that's it. That is my new translated equation. This tells me I went to the right by 3 and I went up, and this gives me this new function right here. Let's go ahead and use that same idea to work on this one here, all right? So this here, the original parent function, this is just y equals the absolute value of x. We know it's absolute because it has this V shaped. And now let's see what happens. Well, to get from here to here, we're gonna go down 2, and then we're gonna go to the left by 1. We go down 2 and to the left by 1. So I'm gonna write this down here, down 2, and we go to the left by 1, okay? So now when I go to write this new equation, I'm gonna write it over here. I'll use, keep in mind that f of x equals the absolute value of x. This is the same thing as y equals the absolute value of x. It's just another way of writing y. So in this case, I used y right over here, whereas up here I used f of x. It really doesn't matter. You can do whichever one you prefer in this case. Well, this is my parent function here. So we're gonna have f of x equals the absolute value of x, okay? If we move to the left, what are we going to do inside? So let's go back at our chart. If we move to the left, what are we going to do inside our functions, inside the input? We're gonna add that number. All right, so you see how there's the parentheses, we're gonna add, it's gonna be x plus whatever number that is. So here, it's gonna be x plus, we went to the left by 1, so x plus 1, now we close the parentheses, okay? And if we went down by 2, If we're going down, let's look at our section here. If we move down, it's going to be minus on the outside. So now we just go here, minus 2. So my final equation is y equals the absolute value of x plus 1 minus 2. And that's it, right? Let's go down to maybe some more examples here. All right, here we go. This is a square root function. This is y equals the square root of x. And this is just y is equal to x. Okay, this is a linear. This is a square root because it has that curviness goes up, all right? Well, from our parent function, from the origin, what happened to get to this new dotted line? Well, we moved to the left by 2. We moved to the left by 2, and then we went down 1. We went down 1. So I'm going to do left by 2, down 1. All right? Use the chart above to see if you can write an equation for this one. Over here, all we did is because it's linear, whether you change the input or the output, it's the same thing. So here we just moved up. So my new equation is going to be here, x plus 2. We just moved up. All right? So that's just the equation for this one here. It's just kind of like this tells us the y-intercept, which is 2. All right, so go ahead and try doing this one. Pause the video and do it on your own. All right, hopefully you're able to do that. Well, let's just go ahead and do this over here from a new equation. So we have y equals the square root of x. Now we're going to move to the left by 2. So it's going to be the square root of x. If we move to the left, let's look up back up here. It's plus, so it's the opposite, so plus 2. And then we move down by 1. And we look here, we'll move down, we put down is minus because we're going into the negative direction, so it's just minus 1. And this is our translated equation. Hopefully that helps you understand translations.